15 hours after a train derailed in Stanislaus County, it's still disrupting service through much of the Central Valley. Live Coverage 3HD is showing you the mess that crews are trying to clean up this morning. The train left the tracks in Denair, east of Turlock. Good morning, I'm Deirdre Fitzpatrick.
And I'm Teo Torres. Now, the accident's impacting passenger lines as well. Brian Hickey has a look at where the investigation, though, stands right now.
Well, crews have worked through the night to try to clear this train off the tracks. Let me show you the amount of work that is going on out here and the heavy machinery they have brought in. Front end loaders, bulldozers, a crane, all to lift up tons of derailed train cars and try to get them back on the tracks after this train came off the tracks just before 5 p.m. last night. The train actually toppled over onto a nearby storage unit, crushing a couple of units there and a boat that's sitting next to the building there. And the good news, however, though, in all of this, nobody was injured, and crews say there is nothing hazardous in these cargo containers. In fact, many of them were empty when the train came off the track. So that is the good news. The bad news, it could be 2 to 3 days before they get all of this cleared up, and that means no cargo train service through the area and no passenger trains either. Amtrak says that service has been cut off between Modesto and Merced. They are busing people around this section of line, but have also stopped selling tickets for that service until this area has been cleared of this wreckage. I talked to one man who was walking home from his brother's house. This is how he described it when the wreck happened.
It started making a funny noise, kind of a clanging noise. The dust started coming up, and then this huge cloud of dust came up that covered everything. You couldn't even see across the road. It was all kind of crashing and grinding and everything. It was quite scary. It was one of the most terrifying things I ever saw.
And residents who live in the area also told me that it was just 2 to 3 weeks ago that crews came through here and replaced most of the railroad ties under this section of line. So that'll be taken into consideration in the investigation of this derailment. Also, some residents felt the train was going a little faster than normal. So something they'll have to take into account as well as they try to figure out what caused this huge mess in Denair. I'm Brian Hickey, KCRA 3 Reports.